At the present time, great attention is paid to the exploration of the north and south poles of the earth by explorers of all nations. Some of the names made famous in connection with polar exploration are Nansen, a Norwegian doctor who sailed in the Fram and succeeded in getting very near to the North Pole, Lieutenant Peary, a daring American who was the first to reach the North Pole, Amundsen, who accompanied Nansen in the Fram and who was the first to discover the South Pole, and Scott, who unfortunately lost his life while returning after having reached the South Pole. Among them, they have added much to geographical knowledge and in a great measure investigators at the present day know as much about these in point of fact as is likely to prove of scientific value. But sooner or later, sentiment rather than science will be gratified by the discovery and publication all over the world of every secret of these untrodden regions. At the present time, great attention is paid to the exploration of the north and south poles of the earth by explorers of all nations. Some of the names made famous in connection with polar exploration are Nansen, a Norwegian doctor who sailed in the Fram and succeeded in getting very near to the North Pole, Lieutenant Peary, a daring American who was the first to reach the North Pole, Amundsen, who accompanied Nansen in the Fram and who was the first to discover the South Pole, and Scott, who unfortunately lost his life while returning after having reached the South Pole. Among them, they have added much to geographical knowledge and in a great measure, investigators at the present day know as much about these in point of fact as is likely to prove of scientific value. But sooner or later, sentiment rather than science will be gratified by the discovery and publication all over the world of every secret of these untrodden regions. Ships of immense proportions are nowadays found in all parts of the world, and docks have to be made deeper and deeper in order to accommodate the huge vessels which are constructed to carry more and more and to travel faster and faster as time advances. Distance between us and foreign parts is becoming less and less, and north and south and east and west are being brought nearer and nearer, so that the desire long since expressed has almost been accomplished, and time and space have been practically annihilated by the progress of science and the ingenuity of man. Ships of immense proportions are nowadays found in all parts of the world, and docks have to be made deeper and deeper in order to accommodate the huge vessels which are constructed to carry more and more and to travel faster and faster as time advances. Distance between us and foreign parts is becoming less and less, and north and south and east and west are being brought nearer and nearer, so that the desire long since expressed has almost been accomplished, and time and space have been practically annihilated by the progress of science and the ingenuity of man. Owing to the peculiar circumstances of the case, such a course as you suggest is out of the question, and you will have to follow the procedure in accordance with precedent. Further, you must endeavor to secure Mr. and Mrs. Brown as witnesses, as their evidence is absolutely necessary. The fact of the matter is that you have failed to bear in mind the really essential features in connection with the case, and have chiefly borne in mind one or two quite subsidiary points. Side by side with this, you have unfortunately displayed a more or less vindictive spirit, which in our opinion can only be prejudicial to the success of your claim. Owing to the peculiar circumstances of the case, such a course as you suggest is out of the question and you will have to follow the procedure in accordance with precedent. Further, you must endeavor to secure Mr. and Mrs. Brown as witnesses, as their evidence is absolutely necessary. The fact of the matter is that you have failed to bear in mind the really essential features in connection with the case and have chiefly borne in mind one or two quite subsidiary points. Side by side with this, you have unfortunately displayed a more or less vindictive spirit, which in our opinion can only be prejudicial to the success of your claim. All parts of the world are becoming, in fact, more and more well known, so that we shall soon regard it as a matter of course that blanks on our maps will grow less and less, till in a short space of time they will disappear altogether. Some may exclaim, "Do you mean to say that at the present time we may, as a matter of fact, look to the time when discoveries will no longer add to our knowledge of the geography of the world in which, from first to last, we have been so much interested? We shall be glad to hear when such may be looked for." In reply, attention may be called to the facts of the case, and by way of illustration, Africa may be pointed to. For many years past, explorers have plunged deeper and deeper into the hidden recesses of the African continent, and whether right or wrong, they subjugated the savage inhabitants in a more or less complete fashion. Africa was then divided among the European powers, and exploration was carried out to a great extent in the last years of the 19th century, so that we are able to make a very complete map of the whole continent. All parts of the world are becoming, in fact, more and more well known, so that we shall soon regard it as a matter of course that blanks on our maps will grow less and less till in a short space of time they will disappear altogether. Some may exclaim, "Do you mean to say that at the present time we may, as a matter of fact, look to the time when discoveries will no longer add to our knowledge of the geography of the world in which from first to last we have been so much interested? We shall be glad to hear when such may be looked for." In reply, attention may be called to the facts of the case, and by way of illustration, Africa may be pointed to. For many years past, explorers have plunged deeper and deeper into the hidden recesses of the African continent, and whether right or wrong, they subjugated the savage inhabitants in a more or less complete fashion. Africa was then divided among the European powers, and exploration was carried out to a great extent in the last years of the 19th century, so that we are able to make a very complete map of the whole continent.